when I left my previous role, which was a result of a sale process of Campbell International, which has been sold to private equity following a 14-15 month long process for the year before. And that's a long time for a business being up for sale. You're talking for multiple international locations, thousands of people, and they are just wondering day by day, what's going on? We are being sold. What's happening? What's next for us? Can we still keep our jobs? Can I still bring, you know, put bread on the table? Simple questions. But you have manufacturing locations and people worrying about their lives. And because I consider my duty of care above anything else, as the leader of the businesses that I'm leading, on several milestones and in a frequent cycle, sort of every 45, 60 days, we would maintain open communication channels with the entire population of several thousand people. Open town halls, non-scripted town halls and Q&A sessions, because these are highly political and high tension environments where critical questions come in, there is unions involved, you have to be careful in what you say. So it's a big minefield from my perspective to deal with this. But you know what? I value what people think and their concerns. So I have to be there to answer their questions. And on occasions, you know, we have visited 20 plus locations or probably close to 30 communication moments in every single wave, covering every location, every shift, and talking to groups in terms of telling them what was happening. Hey, our business is up for sale, describing the situation. This is what's happening. This is how we're executing it. These are the current outcomes. This is what we learned so far. And this is what's going to happen next. So kind of debriefing. It doesn't have to be, you know, blocks. You can build it into your conversation and have the same outcome. And as you can guess, they appreciated it big time. Because if, you know, the highest office in the business goes in front of the people and talks to them in an open way, in an authentic way, that's usually valued. You cannot make everybody happy 100%. That's okay. That comes with the job. There will be always some cynical and critical people. But hey, if I keep 95% happy, I've done a good job. So that's how I look at it. Any questions so far?